What?
Boy, I don't think they're ready for this.
These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. Pull up on them and it look nice. Look nice.
These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future.
Yeah, we look nice. Future looking nice. We don't need to tell them twice.
Here comes the future.
Yeah, we look nice. Future looking real nice. We don't need to tell them twice.
Here comes the future.
Welcome to NetStrata Jubilee Stadium in Kogarah for round two of the Isuzu Ute A-League Men's as Sydney FC host MacArthur. So Alex Wilkinson leading out his side in A-League Men's match number 323. What a record that is. Alex Jovanovic will be a key at the other end of the ground for the Bulls. So the scene is set at NetStrata Jubilee Stadium, and the Sky Blues are unchanged from their opening round derby draw against Wanderers. But coach Steve Corriker wants more cutting edge in the final third, similar to what they showed in the Cup midweek when they put four past Sydney Olympic. Lafondra, Kamsova and Bahaja all scored. They start tonight, and Ryan Grant plays his 250th match for Sydney FC across all competitions. Milos Ninkovic was almost tempted to join MacArthur for their inaugural season, but instead he begins his seventh in Sky Blue. The reigning Johnny Warren medalist up against the man he'll come up against tonight in the Bulls lineup in Ulysses Davila. And there's two changes for Ante Milicic's men from that draw against the Phoenix in the opening weekend. Jordan Much is out of the side with a hamstring strain, replaced in midfield by Tommy Orr. James Meredith drops back to the bench, replaced by Moody Najjar in the left wing back role. There could be some potential MacArthur debuts for attackers Tommy Urich and Al-Hassan Toure. And the temptation to play for the Bulls and under Ante Milicic was too great for Ulysses Davila, who made the switch from Wellington in the off-season. He's building his combination with Danny Da Silva in midfield. And isn't that an exciting combination? Experienced referee Stephen Lucas in charge for this match day two clash in the Isuzu Ute A-League Men's. So two Sydney rivals go in search of their first win of the season. Sydney FC taking on MacArthur. The third time in A-League men's history these two clubs meet. And it's a very good evening to Daniel McBrain.
Good evening, Ben. Welcome, everyone. Looking forward to this one. It's been off the back of Sydney FC's last week, a nil-all draw, but obviously a quite entertaining derby with Western Sydney, and we saw MacArthur a slow burn in the first half, really couldn't really penetrate too much and really grew into the game in the second half and took it to their opponents. So another Sydney derby here for these two to get up for, and what more can you ask with last year's joint Johnny Warren medalists both in the teams opposing each other, as we see them in the screen there. Sears on the ball here as a player from many years ago at Central Coast Mariners in training sessions, that if you didn't want to give the ball away, you couldn't get it off him. So very technically gifted, very strong on the ball, very smart player. It's good to see him go on and, you know, really forge a great career.
So let's get a look now at Saris' set piece. He's dinking towards that back post. Wilkinson was making the run. Deflection on the way through. Fell nicely for Lafondra. Flag is up for offside. his speed. Just gets in front of Jovanovic. Pulls him out of place and now finds Ninkovic. Trent Bahadur. Got numbers back behind the ball. Now turned over. Problems for MacArthur. Bahadur smothered by Curto. And now King trying to knock it back in. But the flag is up for offside.
They just couldn't clear their lines, MacArthur, and it was Bahadur just on his heels a little bit, just in that offside position, but Curto spread himself well. A polling goal, I like that one, Ben.
Nodding it into the path of Davila, shrugs off Retre, who returns, and now De Silva, Rose! Red hot Lockie Rose is catching fire again in Cogra. Four goals in his last three, and the Bulls lead.
Well, he can't stop scoring at the moment, can he? And you see it's Davila again on the Harvey Norman replay. Real tussle with Retre. But watch the movement from Rose. He just skips in and pulls up to the back post. And as Davila comes forward, a little touch. You see, really fighting there, Davila. He could have gone easily down for the free kick. Forward on, plays that ball cross. De Silva with the touch, and Lockie Rose, Johnny on the spot, had pulled off to that back post. Takes a touch, slots it in the bottom corner, and he cannot stop scoring. 1-0 to MacArthur.
What a start to the season for that young man, Lockie Rose, plucked from NPL 2 to join the Bulls last season, and now he's their leading goal scorer. A couple of matches in to season 17 of the A-League men's. What a turnaround for the 22-year-old Lockie Rose. Rose, neat ball to De Silva, away from Warland, who stuck out an arm and a leg, and will give away the free kick. Will there be further punishment for Ben Warland? So Noon and De Silva, the options for this set piece. Noon bending it across. Neat work from Craig Noon. Is there a penalty? Ninkovic says no. The assistant has not flagged for it. And you heard Craig Noon. He said it's a stonewall pen. Ante Milicic thinks it's a stonewall pen as well. I'm certain VAR will have a look at this.
Well, they have to, Ben. And if it's a... if they can see that there's contact, then let's have a look here. He sells the dummy, comes inside. Ninkovic leaves that left foot out. As he comes back, you see Ninkovic, he steps out. Noon goes over the leg.
I think everyone in the ground thought it was a penalty. Lafondra swivels and slides Bahadur into some space. Bahadur's ball spilled by Curto. All of a sudden, the Bulls keeper is just having a few issues, and Sydney FC are interested.
Let me look here. See, he has a little look inside, sees he needs to hold up the play, keeps bringing the ball in, and it's the block from Najjar, I believe. Almost took it past Curto to Ninkovic, who was stealing it at the back post, begging for a tap in.
Caceres. But that is the issue for Sydney. They've been forced to shoot from that kind of range, frustrated by the Bulls' defence.
You can see the frustration there on Caceres' face. What'd you say, Ben? If you're Philip Curto, you're happy for him to be shooting from that range. He has scored the odd screamer in his career, but you know your defence is doing a good job when you're forcing the opposition to shoot from there. Hey!
Rose. Najar linking with the goal scorer in this first half, Lockie Rose. Oh, taking on retro, Lockie Rose, full of confidence. He could be one of the stories of the season if he can keep that kind of form up. Lockie Rose just taking on defenders and unleashing.
Well, you said it, Benny, full of confidence you see here. 1v1, little shimmy, brings it back inside and a nice strike. Redmayne can only parry away.
Into space, Harja Rose. And that is the end of the first half at Netstrata Jubilee Stadium. Sydney have won six straight here. They have got an uphill battle ahead of them if they are to make it seven. And that is due to one man, Lockie Rose, who made it four goals in his last three. And Milos Ninkovic come up with something in the second half to bring the home side back into the contest. Halftime, Sydney FC 0, MacArthur 1. So a chilly night at Netstrata Jubilee Stadium, but Sydney FC are going to have to bring the heat in this second half. And we're back underway. They're going to have to come from behind as they did in the FFA Cup midweek. And Daniel McBreen, what's the best way for the Sky Blues to go about that?
Well, we heard Steve Corriker there saying they need more runs in behind, more balls in behind. We saw Bahaja, Kansoba in particular, down the right-hand side try that, but very well defended from Moody Najar and Alexander Sushnia.
Whoa, there's a falcon from Stephen Lucas. Unintentional header. I've never seen that before. Have you, Macca?
Not on that scale, no. Fantastic. Well, he even got right down to get the head on the ball. Normally you get up to get the header, but he's ducked down well. See Noon playing on this right-hand side. A more attacking play. You'd think the space would be in behind Craig Noon on this near side. Here he is again. He just uses his body. Just a little tug on the shoulder.
Davila looking for his first goal in MacArthur colours. So is this man, Craig Noon, taking on King. Wilkinson Mombwa on the volley, audacious.
He's so dangerous, Craig Noon. He can come inside on his left or outside, like this time on his right.
Now Bahaja, here's just some space in behind here for Sydney. Lafondra! Smart save from Curto. Retray replaced by Neuenhoff. Neuenhoff making his first appearance in the A-League men's since April due to a back issue, so good to see him back out there, the 20-year-old, and Trent Bahaja. Had some good moments tonight for Sydney FC. Now replaced by Pat Wood. Buscock met it at the fall. Caceres in again, Lafondra! How is that missed? You just felt the back of the net was about to bulge.
Well, that was a great ball in, wasn't it? The initial ball comes in, out it goes again. You see here Caceres just whips it, uses the defender as a guide, and Lafondra nips across that front post. Strains the neck muscles, just can't find that near post.
Kemsova, Ninkovic. Gee, it was a little awkward for Philip Curto. It didn't have the power behind it, but it was hit first time and had to get down quite swiftly.
Yeah, it was a difficult one for Milos Ninkovic as well. I'm sure Steve Corica wouldn't mind another howitzer like he scored last year.
Wood. Sharp from Curto. Speaking of howitzers, that Wood can absolutely nail them when they stay hit. So he'll be keen to grab another one tonight, a second one this week. The 18-year-old. Wilkinson appeals for handball. And now the strike from Neuenhoff. Not quite the howitzer we saw against Wellington that Daniel McBreen was alluding to, but they could have an opportunity here, Sydney, if VAR deems there was a handball in the box. Now, just imagine the reaction from the MacArthur bench if this is awarded a penalty.
You can see De Silva, his arms up against his body, tight against his body. Side on, hits his elbow, but it's tucked into his body.
Ryan Grant. And here is Wood. First time side netting for Sydney FC. They are getting closer and closer to Sky Blues.
Well, they attacked in numbers, Sydney FC. And as they broke, the ball came inside to Wood. You see his touch just comes down off his leg and takes it away from him. Sees him having to stretch for the ball. And it's that little touch off the leg as it goes away just stops him from wrapping that foot around the ball. Can only hit the side netting.
Once again, the scrambling defence from MacArthur up to the task. They're going to be tested by Camp Sova. Decent block there from Rose. And now Wood, here is a free kick for Sydney, and here is a yellow card on the way for Alex Sushniak. The first of the game, it's taken a while.
You can hear Alex Wilkinson saying there was something similar, and that one was a similar. He's had a couple of tussles with some of the Sydney players, but the arm was raised there. He actually catches Wood straight across the head. Oof, that's a bad one, right across the face.
First up, it'll be James Meredith who's going to head out onto Netstrata Jubilee Stadium. Shushnia off, Meredith on, and Lockie Rose. What a performance from him tonight. A little more quiet in the second half, but in the first, he was electric. Scored the opening goal, the only goal of this match so far. Almost had a second. That pass from Wood. Not his best. Adam Lafondre now diving in there. Some frustration from the Englishman. It's just building here on Sydney FC. Every miss, just building and building the frustration for the Sky Blues. Not quite the night for Milos Ninkovic. Max Burgess onto the park now. Big moment here for Caceres. Curto pours it away. MacArthur fans breathe a sigh of relief. Anything could have happened there. Still all hands to the pump. Burgess booked away by Najjar. Only as far as Grant. And Burgess is straight offside.
He didn't want the return pass. He couldn't get back onside quick enough. But it was a dangerous cross from the corner as we see Milos Ninkovic. Quiet night for him.
De Silva. And Duffield's first touch let him down on the second attempt. The back heel, it was tricky stuff. Still MacArthur, they cannot finish Sydney FC just yet. Kemp Soba with a chest of Craig Noon. Did well to cut it out, but there's still space here for King as Wood alongside. Wood. Not going to beat Philip Curto with that kind of delivery.
Oof, yep. See Alec Wilkson studs in the calf, followed through from the pass.
No protection from the shin pad there. So Jake Holman, who spent some time at Sydney FC, did not play for them in the A-League men's. He's now going to replace Danny De Silva. 3 goals in 5 appearances for the Northbridge Bulls in the NPL New South Wales in the season just gone. He's a bright young prospect. Meredith regained his balance. Found Najjar. Holman. How about the turn from Jake Holman all the way, cutting it back towards Urich. And now confusion. Davila finally cleared by Neuenhoff. A near thing for Sydney FC. And problems for Uzcock. He's into the book for sure.
Well, as we look at the confirmation of yellow card for Uzcock, still don't know how Sydney got that ball away. And as Lafondra was getting away, it's the third or fourth challenge we've seen like that tonight.
They have to go forward and fast. Sydney FC camps over, good speed away from Najjar. There'll be a set piece on the way for the Sky Blues. Najjar into the book. He can give away that free kick and grab a yellow card.
You can see hands all over Cam Sober there. Dangerous situation. It's probably last roll of dice for Sydney here.
And they're sending up Andrew Redmayne as well. The only goalkeeper to have scored in the A-League is Danny Vukovic from a penalty. That was for Wellington a few years back. Could Redmayne become the second?
It's something we always love to see. Goalkeepers up in the last minute.
Caceres is in towards Redmayne, but cut off at the near stick.
Caceres will be disappointed with the delivery, not beating the first man. Everyone up, including the goalkeeper, just can't get lifted over the first defensive player.
And the Bulls break down Fortress Kogra for the second match in a row. The 6-match winning streak for the Sky Blues here at home is over at the hands of the MacArthur Bulls. They love playing here. And Lockie Rose is loving playing football at the moment. 4 goals in his last 3 matches across the A-League Men's and the FFA Cup. And what a sterling defensive effort from that man's team. Ante Milicic will be so proud of them. Rose will grab the headlines, but Uzcock, Jovanovic and Shushnia should take a bow. Full time, Sydney FC 0, MacArthur FC 1.